Fruit Berries, a mechanical god that dominates many different parts of the game. I've already done Dream, I've already done Techno, you know it's time to do the green god himself, Fruit Berries. I spent a ton of time on this video and I would really appreciate your support, so if you can, just subscribe, like, you know the drill boys. I really just want to get into it though, so without further ado, let's get started. Fruit manages to succeed in 1.8 and 1.9 plus PvP, but first let's start off by just going into 1.8. The thing that separates Fruit from other players is by the way he aims. If you watch any video where Fruit focuses just on his movement, you can see how deliberate and careful his aim is. He intentionally smoothens his aim to make it look better for the video, and it literally works so much, it's literally just ASMR for your eyes. To aim like Fruit, you'll need to have incredible tracking aim, like literal aimbot. He normal clicks, but can butterfly as well, which is why he has such a steady aim. If you watch anyone that jitters, it's pretty obvious that they're jittering since it looks like they're in the middle of an earthquake. If we compare his steady tracking aim styles to other PvPers, such as 1.9 shield mains, it makes sense that they usually have more flick-based aim, considering 1.9 shield is more about baiting attacks and making sudden movements and plays. Fruit came from the UHC community playing 1.8, which makes his aim style extremely unique. Watch any Rod PvPer and they almost always flick and move with really fast mouse movements. Fruit has an extremely unusual aim style because his aim is so deliberate in most situations. He rarely flicks fast at all and instead just slowly tracks enemies and moves very slowly. Even in 1.16, we see this exact same aim style. When he PvPs, every mouse movement seems super deliberate and calculated. He almost always tries to keep his crosshair around the enemy and slowly drags it along to aim instead of flicking it around and being as erratic as some other players. To summarize how you can aim like Fruit, use slow mouse movements and focus on just tracking your enemy as well as you can. Now let's move on to his movement. Fruit's movement in PvP is also super unique. As a UHC player from Hypixel, he relies a lot on Rod combos to hold people in a combo, but when he doesn't have a Rod, he tends to abuse strafes to win fights. I know I talk a lot about why CPS doesn't really matter unless you're playing against genuinely good opponents, but Fruit probably knows his low CPS is a disadvantage if he were to get into trades. High CPS basically evolves you into a brick wall and lets you take a lot of hits with very little KB, making it easier to win trades since you'll get more double hits. Fruit certainly knows this and rarely straight lines people in almost any situation. As if they're good and happen to have more CPS than him, then he could end up trading with them and getting thrown around like a used tissue. Because of this, you'll see Fruit strafe hard to one side to hold a lot of combos, but also hold really good side-to-side strafes. If you don't know why, by the way, just watch this video I made on comboing, it'll help you out. For 1.9, it's basically the same exact thing for Sword PvP. He spam crits when he can, but otherwise his effective strafe patterns help him kill people pretty easily. In the wise words of the other green dude, Fruit is literally a cheat code. I just want to give up getting mechanically better every time I see something like this. I'm not trying to start debates on who is better, I literally couldn't care less. I'm just here to overanalyze Minecraft YouTubers to an unhealthy degree, not start World War 3 in the comments. The clip that Dream commented on was a video of Fruit making up his own bridge where he 360s between each block. Fruit is honestly known for this, just pioneering stupid strategies that take the Minecraft community by storm. To begin, let's look at his parkour gauntlets. Remember this YouTube trend? Yeah, that was actually started by Fruit. His amazing movement with blocks is almost unmatched by anyone. It combines his incredible aim with amazing parkour ability to dodge and weave around blocks in an effortless fashion. To achieve this ability, I'd honestly just recommend downloading one of the maps he uses or playing obstacles on Bedwars practice to get good at these skills. As for the individual parts of the gauntlets, most of it is just good timing and aim, which just comes with practice. Although the best way to do this one part where you place two blocks up is by timing a butterfly click. Personally, I call it a double jump, and this is how I do it, by just quickly butterflying with two fingers, so both my fingers click right after each other, then aiming down slightly and running to the very edge of the first two blocks up. It's not that hard once you get the timing down. If you just want to practice double jumps and triple jumps, I'd recommend going into a flat survival world, slash giving yourself a million wool blocks, and then just Fortniting all over the place. The next trend Fruit started was this fruit bridging craze. You've probably seen videos everywhere of people doing this new bridge. It's super satisfying to watch. If you don't know, it's a bridging technique he's been doing for many months, which started as a meme but slowly became really, really good. I even asked Sowo, the fruit bridging god himself, if it's more of a meme strat or actually a viable bridge. He admits it's genuinely good for rushing in games like Skywars since it's really good for a quick burst of speed. The way Fruit does it involves placing a block and quickly 180ing and going right away. It's probably the fastest possible bridging method for 5 to 10 block distances aside from telebridging, which is impossible on Hypixel by the way, because you know you'll get server lag and ghost blocks and it's not even fun, man. Because of that, I'm pretty sure it's literally the fastest possible bridge for covering short distances on Hypixel. Since it takes forever to line up God Bridges and Breezily, it's probably way slower in comparison. As for teaching you how to do this, I think Soho explains it best, so I'd recommend just watching his video if you're curious how to do it. Because of Fruit's background as a UHC trapper, he thrives when being chased. His block placing abilities and smooth movement not only make him hard to catch, but chasing him is a big risk. He pioneered and popularized so many different trapping strats over the years that if you chase close behind him, you could easily fall into a trap at literally any moment and get destroyed. This creates a really cool dynamic as he can repeatedly annoy you into chasing him before running away and baiting you into a trap. Or even better, he can pressure the enemy into thinking he will trap, which makes them more paranoid and lets him get away safely or at least be really annoying. This sounds super stupid, but even if he never built a trap, just his reputation alone as a trapper makes it scary chasing him in UHC or basically any other PvP game mode, since you wouldn't want to get caught off guard and get clipped. Having the reputation as a capable trapper is extremely powerful, as it means your enemy will have to adapt to your rules. Again, I said something similar in my techno video about his reputation as a player, so this isn't really something you could replicate on your own, but it's still something to note. This doesn't mean that you can't use similar strategies, as playing very passive and running well is a great strategy as it may make people think you're trapping. Flipping over to newer clips of Fruit PvPing, we can see Fruit playing Sky Battle in recent MCCs. Fruit is one of the best MCC PvPers for sure, and because of this, he tends to get teamed with players that are not as good in PvP and dominate more in team-based games. Fruit's strats are honestly great in Sky Battle, as he almost always stays with his team since he knows they won't be comfortable taking on dominant PvP teams. Another connection we can make is in MCC All-Stars with the new Battle Box map. Fruit went absolutely crazy, beating up a bunch of better PvP teams by using a passive strat that he has yet again pioneered. Basically, he saw that the middle part of the map was elevated, so using his big rain parkour, he hard rushed mid with blocks and filled in the wall instantly without ever having to fight a single person. This didn't get him extra points, since you get points for getting kills in MCC, but it did give him points for winning the round, which was extremely important. This get walled strategy ended up winning 8 of the 9 rounds he played, and along the way, he even got some kills, which helped secure his team for first place overall in the whole game against other teams that were far better than him at PvP. Whether he's in the middle of a sweaty UHC, intense Sky Battle match, or even an unknown Battle Box map, Fruit's passiveness is a great trait that you need to replicate if you want to play like him. Anyone that plays this game knows how good Fruit is. Backtracking to Fruit's UHC days, we can look back a couple years ago to UHC On Air Season 10, where Fruit went into his main game against a bunch of people that knew he was a trapper. Despite everyone knowing he was going to trap, he managed to trap someone and get full diamond, later losing to Nikolai, who was extremely happy to kill him because he knew how much of a threat Fruit was. Just keep this example in mind, as there are going to be many other examples of people hard targeting Fruit because they know how good he is. Another great example of his reputation is in a recent Minecraft Twitch Rivals organized by Noah PikaClix. The format was super simple. It's a 1.8 PvP event where captains can draft players from groups of 8 evenly skilled players. There are 7 draft rounds total, so the players will basically be split up evenly on skill. Sort of like how kids would have team captains pick for kickball back in elementary school. I was always picked last, by the way. It's another sad day for Yellowbed. In every single round Fruit was available, he was picked first because he's a mechanical monster, and again, everyone knows that. But oddly enough, HannahXXRose, who is great friends with Fruit, didn't pick him first, even though she had a first round draft pick. Her logic for not picking him is actually really good. Just listen to this clip.
The reason I didn't choose Fruit is because everyone... The thing about having Fruit is everyone targets him so hard, so he can't pull his fruit berries... shenanigans. Do you know what I mean?
She justifies her point later on by saying that she went against Fruit's team in another event and she made the call out to hard target Fruit. She's longtime friends with Fruit since they both came from the Hypixel UHC community, which was relatively small and tight-knit back in the day. Like she says, Fruit needs space to be able to make plays, like any person, but especially for him because of how he plays. When Fruit's in a raw PvP environment, no one thrives like him. Look at MCC 9, easily the greatest MCC among dedicated MCC fans. I was alive, by the way, as I've watched every single MCC from his POV since he joined in MCC 6, so I am very heavily biased when I say that, but it still shows off Fruit's ability to clutch up when given the space he needs. Let's set the stage. It's the 7th of 8 games, and there are 4 more games available to pick in the Decision Dome. Big Sales at Buildmart, Sands of Time, Bingo But Fast, and Survival Games. Fruit's team, the Blue Bats, really wants anything but SG, as they're better at team games and suck at PvP. Unfortunately, Survival Games was picked, and everyone audibly groaned, assuming it's all over for their team as they were not confident in PvP whatsoever. Despite this though, Fruit's team went to the border, picked fights smartly, had perfect comms, effectively cleaned kills, and played overall amazing, sweeping the game with 14 kills and all 4 players left alive, getting 7,200 coins and securing their place in Dodgeball. It was literally a scripted story, like this team was slept on so hard for so long. This unironically could be like a plot of an anime or something. It literally just feels staged, since once I had the fact that they ended up reverse sweeping the enemy in Dodgeball, it was just a cherry on top. By the way, to explain what I mean by given space, it's basically when he isn't hard targeted or teamed on. Fruit thrives in chaotic environments where everyone is just stabbing each other and no one knows what's going on, as he can go brain AFK and just roll everyone with his raw mechanics. That's another reason he was so consistent in Minecraft Ultimate, consistently getting high kill games, but getting targeted because, again, he was agreed upon as one of the best players in the event. The 8 kill massacre he got in MCC9 isn't just a one-time thing either. He absolutely mauled everyone in MCC16 and yet another chaotic SG where Fruit was yet again given lots of space and decent loot to stand a chance in fights. By the way, as I was recording this video, I watched MCC19 and he did it a third time. This man is he's just the greatest SG player, man. I don't know what to say. If you don't get what I'm going for here, to PvP like Fruit, you'll need to be able to take fights and win consistently when given space. Well, you might ask, how can I win in chaotic environments? Well, now I'll explain some of the different strats Fruit uses, such as target priority and understanding of advantages in fights. Target priority is probably one of the best skills anyone can have. The first example that I have is the first Twitch Rivals Minecraft that Fruit won, which I talked about earlier. His team absolutely rolled everyone, playing 5 different teams and only dropping 1 map throughout the entire event. Part of this was because his team was super stacked, but it also was because of Fruit's target priority. For example, in this fight, Fruit hard flanks behind the entire enemy team, and while their healer was busy healing, he perfectly crit them out till they were 1 hit away. Unfortunately, he got hit away, but again, he knew that getting the kill on the person that was low was more important than getting a bunch of damage on people, and even while getting hit, he managed to hit this crazy snipe as they ran off. He did this almost every round, sneaking around and playing annoying to get the enemy's attention, and then hard focusing one player in the middle of a fight by critting them out. I love this play here where he just hard focuses Harvey. Like, there's tons of other players around here, but he knows that Tapple's their best player, so he just locks his aimbot on them since he knows they're the highest priority target on their team. A normal player would just start clicking randomly, but Fruit locks on a target and just rolls them till they look like Flat Stanley. Like, this dude he crits out here and locks on in Minecraft Ultimate is widely regarded as one of the best 1.16 PvPers ever. And because Fruit's locked on him and there's so much happening, there's literally nothing the guy can do. Again, there's literally 30 people left in this small 10x10 box. A normal person would just swing around randomly, but Fruit knows securing a kill is better than just getting someone low, especially when someone's as good as Tryhard, who is very good at the game. Alright, but this is a bad example considering Minecraft Ultimate got cancelled harder than a Dream SMP streamer. By the way, rip MCU, that techno video will live in my memory forever, it's such a good event. How about we compare it to Bed Wars, since that's the only game I've ever been good at. Let's say you're playing 4s and taking a 4v4 fight rank style. As a team, you should try and focus one guy or crit out one person to start, usually their best player. By eliminating one target with target priority, you've instantly made it a 3v4 and ruined the enemy's morale as they're down their best player. Again, this isn't the only thing that Fruit's good at in every single game. He's also very good at playing slow and knowing when to engage in fights. Let's look at Fruit's MCC 14 Sky Battle to prove my point. After his whole team died in the middle, Fruit is left in a 1v7 and meticulously takes down every single one of the enemy players in my all-time favorite MCC play. Fruit's ability to play slow and his selective targeting here is super strong, as he takes fights and splits up players by spleefing, hitting them away, or just killing them. The only reason he's able to win this is because of how well he took each fight, treating it more like 7 1v1s instead of a big 1v7, which is a lot easier in comparison. Notice how when he's beating up the 2 red players, he tries his best to only focus Vicstar, as securing the kill on one player that's low is better than getting 2 people low. After that, he jumps down, kills Tapple, and immediately jumps into a pit with Wisp. He uses height advantage to blow up the people below him, then low ground to spleef a bunch of people, and then beat up the last 2 players since they can't reach him from this angle. He then surprises both Tapple and Wisp by jumping on both them suddenly. An amazing play displaying target priority and how you should take fights individually and one at a time, not trying to brawl everyone all at once, as that's just gonna get you killed. Anyone can learn these skills, it has absolutely nothing to do with your mechanics. It's just a matter of getting in the habit of thinking differently. Another theme we can keep seeing is Fruit thriving when he gets time to be an idiot. It might sound like a joke, but I'm being serious. Fruit plays best when he's given time to experiment, work through, and solve problems in any single game. I already mentioned this earlier, but the Fruit bridge that he invented just comes from him memeing around for fun. By the way, I can totally see so many losers running in the comments and freaking out like, actually the speed tele bridge is approximately 1.2 blocks per second faster according to my calculations. Like, bro, shut up, it's all for fun, man. Another strat he discovered through experimentation was the forge trap in Hypixel UHC. NPC. If you don't know, if you get someone in a 1x1 hole in Hypixel and place a forge, which is just an instant smelting furnace you can craft, it will actually be permanently stuck in that block. The reason this works is because the forge has a name tag on top of it, and for some reason Hypixel decided to put this name tag inside an invisible armor stand which lays right underneath the forge. Because of this, if you stand directly under the forge, every hit you will make will be blocked by this invisible armor stand, so you can't move, break blocks, or even eat. Again, Fruit discovered this glitch, and it was extremely common to see it used all across Hypixel, but unfortunately it was patched out, so you can't do it anymore. What does any of this have to do with how to PvP like Fruit Berries? I'll be honest, I have no clue, but it does show a lot about how Fruit thinks. Lots of players just stick to the meta exclusively in any game. Remember when God Bridging was just this thing that only German players could do like 2 to 3 years ago, and North American players treated it like this myth that people spread around while huddled around the campfire? I remember seeing my first God Bridger and thinking this guy was cheating or something, like I was staring up at the sky in pure horror, like I was looking up at the Colossal Titan in AOT. Now you can go into literally any Bed Wars game and there'll be 84 different people with super OG names and their entire personalities that they can drag click 30 CPS and God Bridge. If you don't get what I'm saying, basically it takes someone willing to experiment with the game and joke around to discover new techs and distinguish themselves as a player, and Fruit has done this time and time again, which is why he's so entertaining to watch and has gained so much clout in the Hypixel community. So for the final tip of this video, Fruit's biggest asset is his creativity in game. Like literally everyone and their mom is doing this Fruit Bridge, like I can't go more than a couple games without some loser jumping up and down like this, I can't take it, man. Final and best example I can think of is an MCC16 Dodgebolt. Fruit went up against Dream, who was undoubtedly the best Dodgebolt player at the time. Despite this, Fruit randomly decided to try and dodge based on prediction and reaction instead of randomly jumping around like everyone had done since MCC1. Without any practice, his new predictive dodge method led him to dodging 16 out of 20 shots aimed at him in front of a million live concurrent viewers. Fruit would watch his enemy and almost react to when they were going to shoot, which was half the time based on reaction and the other half based on prediction. This is probably the dumbest thing he could have done in that situation, as he could have embarrassed himself in front of literally everyone. But you know what? That's just Fruit for you. So that's my final tip for the video. Be stupid, be creative, and do dumb stuff, because that's how you can PvP like Fruit Berries. Thanks for watching, gamers. Again, make sure you like, sub, you know the drill. Just do it, man. I'm not gonna pull up the numbers. I'm not a nerd, dude. That's why I make Minecraft videos. All right, join the Discord at least. We got a ton of cool people there, and you can play games with people and talk to me and stuff. I'm super active. I respond to like every message. That's going to be it for this video. I hope you guys enjoy. I'll see you guys next time.